Hi, I'm Brigham Larson with Brigham Larson Pianos, and I'm at the Petrof Piano Factory outside of Prague. And what I want to highlight in this video, this is what sets fine European pianos, in this case Petrof, apart from other piano makers. Downbearing is a big deal, a really, really big deal. Now what that is, we have, this is the area of the factory where they set the downbearing. What we have here is the soundboard and the bridge. They bring the plate on top, set it down, put it exactly where in the position it's going to be, and they're setting the downbearing. Now what that is the piano strings, of course, they look like they're perfectly parallel to the soundboard, but really they're going slightly up to the bridge and then down to the hitch pin on the plate somewhere around here where they hook on. So when they're under tension, they're pushing down on that on the soundboard, and the soundboard is slightly kind of dome shaped, very slightly. It's called crown that pushes back. So you've got the soundboard pushing up, you've got the strings when they're under tension pushing down, and that's what really gives you transfer of a beautiful tone into the soundboard. What makes it an amplifier and makes it a really appealing sound. On a side note, just to kind of punctuate or expand on that a little bit, I saw a demonstration, very, very good demonstration, of a tuning fork that was fastened to a piece of soundboard material, and that soundboard material had two little handles on either side. You hit the tuning fork with a little mallet, and the tone is very thin and weak and just kind of a boring tone. And then when you grab those handles and kind of squeeze it, that tone just comes alive. And then if you squeeze it too much, it kills the tone again. So it's a very exact. And so this is where downbearing comes into play. You've got the crown of the soundboard, you've got the strings bearing down on the bridge. Okay, and this is the point that I'm trying to make, where it really sets apart with other piano makers. Other piano makers, what they do in this section of building the piano is, you know, they have specs. They build the soundboard to the specs. They build the bridge to the spec, and they put the strings on, and they call it good, and it's probably close enough. However, you're dealing with living, breathing materials, wood in particular. There are also, inevitably, in every piano, very slight anomalies that can even build up to this step, and you've got differences that are large enough that if you would just throw the strings on as is, you know, it'll still be good, it'll still be a piano. You know, I'm a lover of pianos, so it'll be great, except it's not a fine piano unless this particular step that I'm going to now get into is taken. Okay. So they put the plate on top, they bring a string across, and they have a very specific amount of bearing with that string. And they do it at various points along the bridge. And with that string, they know that it's intentionally too high. They take a saw and very gently slice down on that bridge until that string has the exact amount of downbearing that they want. So you've got a cut, you know, at various locations of exactly the depth that you want that string to go. So it's downbearing, again, the angle at which it slopes up to the bridge and then the angle at which it slopes back down. So that downbearing is exactly where it's supposed to be. And then they take it over to the machine and even out those cuts so that everything is even and smooth and exactly downbearing that it's supposed to be. That is a fine piano building practice.